Good morning.
That's a little loud.
Good morning, one and all. Good to see you as we come to worship our Lord. If you can see, I don't have much voice. I don't have much voice this morning. So I'm trying to choose a different microphone this morning that would help me project a little bit. I got a lot of echo. I'm going to turn that down just a tad. Just talk about yourselves. Reformation Sunday, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Jesus said, if you abide in my word,
you are truly my disciples,
and you will know the truth. With humble hearts, let us approach our Father's throne of grace. And together we pray, gracious Father, because of our entire lives are to be books of repentance, we bow before you and confess our sins. We have turned away of your word, choosing to go our own way. By what we have thought, by what we have done, and by what we have failed to do, we have broken your commands and are deserving of your wrath and punishment. By the mercy of Christ, your Son, set us free from our captivity. Enable us by your Holy Spirit to live under you in your blessing, to serve you in everlasting righteousness, innocence, and blessedness. Amen. Just as Christ is risen from the dead, he lives and reigns to all eternity. It is most certainly true that he died and rose again for you, to make you right with God, to adopt you as children of the Heavenly Father, and to set you free from sin and death. As a called and ordained servant of the Word, I therefore forgive you all of your sins, in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our hymn of praise this morning, all glory to you, to God on high. faithful people. Keep us steadfast in your grace. Protect and deliver us in times of temptation. Defend us against all enemies. And through the abiding word of your Son, set us free from our sin, that we may know and sustain peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated.
The first reading is taken from Revelation chapter 14, starting at the 6th verse. Then I saw another angel flying directly overhead with an eternal gospel to proclaim to those who dwell on earth, to every nation and tribe and language and people. And he said with a loud voice, "Fear God and give him glory, because the hour of his judgment has come, and worship him who made heaven and earth, the sea and the springs of water." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm reading for this morning is Psalm 46, beginning with all of us responsibly, "The Lord our host is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. God is our refuge and strength, very aggressive help in trouble.
Therefore, we will not fear, though we go this way,
though the mountains be moved
to the heart of the sea,
though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble at its swelling.
There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the whole habitation of God.
God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God will help her when the morning dawns.
We teach the rich, the king is not our. He utters his voice, the earth melts.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come, behold the works of the Lord, how he has brought desolations on the earth.
He makes the waters cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the chariots of the fire.
Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth.
The Lord of hosts is with us.
The God of Jacob is our fortress.
Reading is taken from Romans chapter 3, starting at the 19th verse. Now we know that whatever the law says, it speaks to those who are under the law, so that every mouth may be stopped, and the whole world may be held accountable to God. For by works of the law, no human being will be justified in his sight, since through the law comes knowledge of sin. But now the righteousness of God has been manifested apart from the law, although the law and the prophets bear witness to it, the righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all who believe. For there is no distinction, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, and are justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a propitiation by his blood to be received by faith. This was to show God's righteousness because, in his divine forbearance, he had passed over former sins. It was to show his righteousness at the present time, so that he might be just and the justifier of the one who has faith in Jesus. Then what becomes of our boasting? It is excluded. By what kind of law? By law of works? No, but by the law of faith. For we hold that one is justified by faith, apart from works of the law. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for our hymn verse, "Lord, keep us steadfast in your word."
Thank you.
So Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in him, "If you abide in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free." They answered him, "We are offspring of Abraham and have never been enslaved to anyone. How is it that you say you will become free?" Jesus answered them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, everyone who commits sin is a slave to sin. The slave does not remain in the house forever, but the son remains forever. So if the son sets you free, you will be free indeed." This is the gospel of the Lord. You may be seated for our hymn. Thank you. from God our Father, and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Friends, for a free donut after church, who can tell me how many years of the Reformation do we celebrate today? Okay, I'll give you a hint. It's more than 500.
Spoken together in the same sentence. You know
no longer spoken today, right? Yeah, you can thank our Democratic House of Representatives for that. Back in 2019, the oath, "So help you God," has been replaced with the words, "under penalty of law." So is Jack Nicholson right? We can't handle the truth? In our case, the idea of returning to God, that His Word is preeminent, that God establishes the basis of our rules and laws and morality and ethics and truth, is more than we can bear. 505 years ago, as we celebrate today, Martin Luther reformed the church. Now, he didn't throw it out. He didn't revolt against it. Luther never meant to break away from the church, the established church, to start a religion of his own, doing his own thing, being a rebel, but to return to the truth, to reform, to straighten out, to correct, to return the church to compliance with biblical truth, to do God first and not man, to apply Scripture as the standard or rule to every facet of church conduct, belief, and worship practice, and to remove man-made rule, tradition, or gross error on the part of man where it violated the Word of God. So today, 505 years later, what have we learned? Well, we've learned that Scripture is more than philosophy. Scripture is witness to truth, to actual events. As God worked salvation, as God worked knowledge of Himself, as God worked His plan for mankind through actual events in human history, established and verified facts. But why do you think they call it witnessing anyway? Like in the courtroom, we give witness. Testimony to truth, what actually happened. We don't just teach or preach, we share evidence of what is factual, established, verifiable fact. 500 people cannot be wrong in their testimony to what they've seen, that Jesus, crucified, died, and buried, has risen from the dead. It's not just a story. It's God's story and our history. A generation of people who saw salvation unfold before their eyes, watching what only God can do, witnessing to what only God in His love would do, to send His Son to die in our place. Because God knew from that day in Genesis, when our eyes were opened to good and evil, and the truth became clouded, heaven's doors became closed. And we could not wish our way, will our way, work our way, or philosophically find our way back into God's grace, or to come to Him in purity, because we had become slaves to sin. Sin had corrupted our hearts, and the wages of that sin was death. A truth that God had already established when He said, regarding that tree of good and evil, when you eat of it, you will die. We cannot evade the truth. So when Jesus died for us, we, connected to Him in baptism, died with Him. Our judgment was paid, truth was maintained, and now we live, again, in a newness of life, forgiven and seen by God as
in a new and glorious baptismal way. My friends, this is all more than just sermon rhetoric. It's gospel truth. This, by the grace of God alone, is something that we just could not do on our own. The Reformation time had its share of religious untruths, and today we have our own. And there are many who cannot handle the truth, and so they create their own truth, a false truth that says there is no God to which we are accountable, or God just saves everybody in the end, or you can live and be as you want to live, believe what you want to believe, it's all good, whatever makes you happy. An untruth that believes that truth is relative, that sin doesn't really matter. What false truth? Otherwise known as a lie. That says the cross of Christ, where Jesus died for sins and for sinners, doesn't really matter. Or those who can't handle the truth, can't believe that salvation is a free gift that's received by faith alone. They believe, Reformation time and today, that people still have to work for their salvation and live a, philosophically speaking, righteous religious life. All while fooling themselves that they can impress God enough to be worthy of heaven, without soul trust in the one thing that can get them there. Our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for them to set them free. But we, who know the truth, can handle the truth. That God sent his one and only Son into our world as evidence to the truth. To do God's will in agreement with the standard and rule, God's holy will, so that from sin, by his rising from death to defeat sin for all of us, you and I could be set free. Jesus' resurrection, the truth, an established and verifiable fact that we all witness to. Yes, we can handle the truth. The Son has set us free, and we are free indeed. Let us bear witness of this freedom by living the Reformation, telling the world the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. So help us God. In a joyous response to the certain and hopeful joy we have that our salvation is secured as baptized children of God. Amen. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. Friends, let us rise as we make profession of our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, and for all people according to their needs.
Jesus, you have freed us from the captivity to sin and death, from the delusion of trying to earn and maintain our own righteousness, and from the chains of condemnation and fear. That is why we rejoice in your word. If the Son sets you free,
you will be free indeed.
Lord Jesus, only your mercy and grace enable us to know, find, and live in freedom of your eternal gospel. Send your Spirit upon your church, and we continue with the truths of the Reformation, and that to all the peoples of the world we proclaim this church, and this truth, that the Son sets you free,
you will be free indeed.
Lord Jesus, free us from self-centeredness and pride. Turn our focus toward you first in faith, and then toward others in love. Bless all who serve you, and others in their homes, in the church, in the workplace, and in our community, to rejoice in knowing that if the Son sets you free,
you will be free.
Lord Jesus, you proclaim freedom for the captives and recovery for those with infirmities. Grant your healing in both body, for soul and body, to those we name before you now. As we lift up to you this day, continued prayer for Sherry Jarvis, Kathleen Johnson, Noreen Nagel, Sherry Kroll, Cornelius O'Keefe, Rich and Shirley Lansdale, continued healing. Lord, we pray that you be with them and give them every measure of healing that they sorely need. As Lord, we also lift up to you our shut-ins, Ethel Burkow, Charles Harvey, Lori Horn, Maxine Dunn, and Betty Roth. And Lord, we ask you to give them the comfort of spirit at this time and always. And Lord, there are many other requests that we have, things that are personal to us. I lift up to you now a prayer of thanksgiving for my daughter, who once again is conceived and will have another child. Lord, this is truly, truly a blessing from you. I thank and praise you for the continuance of our family. And Lord, for the other prayers that we lift up to you now from the Lord. Lord, as you hear these things brought before you, all the needs of both body and spirit. So, Lord, rejoicing in your healing touch, grant that all will receive your good news, boldly saying, if the Son sets you free,
you will be free.
Lord Jesus, for these and all other concerns that we have, please hear and answer our prayers according to your gracious will. And we live each day in the freedom of you may be seated. is truly good, right, and salutary, and we should at all times and at all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened us to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and singing.
Thank you.
And may the body and blood of our Lord strengthen and preserve your steadfast in the true faith until life everlasting. Depart in peace. Amen. Please rise.
Friends, go in peace, serve the Lord, thanks be to God.